Good morning. Today we are going to learn the next chapter, that is chapter 4, determinants. See, before going to see the determinants, first let us recall the matrix, because from the matrix only we are going to learn the determinants. A matrix, it is an ordered rectangular array of number of functions. Inside, it is a rectangular array. It is an ordered rectangular array. Here we have either the number or function. For this we have order of the matrix also, that is row into column. See, here we have taken a order of 2×2. See, it is a rectangle, so we can have any number of rows and any number of columns there. Even single row also we can have, or even we can have single column also. So whatever so the matrix we have, we can write the order of the matrix there, that is allowed in the rectangular array, that is allowed in the matrices. Any order we can write any matrix. But in determinants, only the selected matrix we are going to select here, that matrices alone we are going to call that as a determinants. What are those matrix are? We are going to take only the square matrix. The first condition is we have to take only the square matrix. To every square matrix, capital A equal to Aij of order n. Order n, why we are writing a single number, means this is of 2×2. Column is also same, row is also same. So I am going to represent this by a single number, that is 2. Here it is 2. Suppose if it is of order 3×3, then I will represent this order as 3. So whatever the number of rows and number of columns are there, that order we will be representing by the single number n. And this matrix, if I associate to a single number, and that is called as a determinants. Now see here, for to every square matrix A equal to Aij of order n, we can associate a number. For each matrix we can give one number there. That number can be a real number or the complex number. That will be the determinant of the given matrix. Now determinant we used to represent by the symbol, this one. This is a symbol for determinants. Before that, we know this is a symbol for modulus. Modulus means the plus sign will also be included, plus minus sign will also be included. Suppose if I am writing of this x means, then we will read this as modulus. But here we are going to take this symbol as for the determinants. This symbol we are going to take it for determinants. This we have to read it as determinant of x. This we have to read it as determinant of A. Usually we will represent by the capital alphabets. Capital alphabets we have to write. Capital letters we have to write here. See here, the determinants can be defined only for square matrix. Determinant is only for the square matrix, not the rectangular matrices. So determinant is allowed only for the square matrices. For a square matrix A, determinant of A can be represented either in this format, or we can write it as DET of A, or we can write this triangular symbol. This symbol also means as determinant only. Then matrix is only a representation. See, this is the representation of ordered numbers or function in a order. The matrix is representation. For this representation, if I find the value, that is called as determinant. So both are interrelated. First I have to represent in an order. For that I have to find the solution. That solution is the determinant. See, representing the elements in order, that representation we have to find the value, that value is the determinant. So matrix is only representation, determinant is a value of the matrix. Determinant is the value of the matrix. Now, if it is so, now let us find the determinant, that is value of matrix of order 1. Suppose if I have 1 cross 1 matrix, then what is the value of that matrix that we are going to find out? Value, instead of saying that simply value, we will say that it is a determinant. So determinant of A matrix of order 1. Now order 1 means, let us take a matrix of order 1. 1 cross 1, 1 row, 1 column, so 1 element I have taken. If it is so, then the matrix of order 1, then the determinant of A is defined to be equal to that A itself. What element is inside here, that will be the value of the matrix of order 1. Suppose if a matrix is equal to 5, if this is so, then the value of this matrix, or the value of this determinant of A is equal to 5. Suppose if I have a matrix, 1 cross 1 matrix of minus 1, then the value of determinant, that is equal to minus 1. That is the determinant of matrix of order 1. Whatever element is there, same will be the value of the matrix. Now, determinant of matrix of order 2. Order 2 means I have to take a 2 cross 2 matrix. Now let us take a 2 cross 2 matrix. See, 2 cross 2 matrix means A11, A12, A21, A22 be a matrix of order 2 cross 2. If it is so, then to find the value, or find the determinant, or we can write this as determinant of A. This also we have treated as determinant of A only. This also we have treated as determinant of A. Suppose if I am using the symbol, this triangular symbol, that is also determinant of A. Simply if I write this one, that is also we have to read that as determinant. So determinant of this matrix A is equal to, if it is of square matrix, what is the procedure is, first thing, we have to take the leading diagonal. Leading diagonal means the entries are ith and jth will be equal. That will be called as leading diagonals. That we have learned in the chapter 3 itself. Now this leading diagonal elements we have to first multiply. That is A11 into A22. With that, subtract the value of the next side of the matrix. Now see here, next side is A21 into A12. Now see here, A11 into A22 minus, we will be writing, see symbol will be in this form, but we will be multiplying. Multiplication means both are same, so either we are writing A12 or 21, both will be same, minus of A21 into A12. So the determinant of A is equal to A11 into A22 minus of A21 into A12. This is called as the value of the determinant. Now let us take a determinant. So let us take a matrix to find the determinant value. See, this is the matrix given. This matrix, first I will be writing in determinant. So I will evaluate this. Evaluate this determinant, that is finding the value. This representation we will be converting to this one. So hereafter they will give the question in this format only. They will not give this matrix here. Only this format they will give. Now this thing we have to find the value. See, 5, 4, minus 1, 2. This is of order 2. This is of order 2. We will not write it as 2 cross 2. So order 2. Now for this we have to find the delta, or determinant of A. this is equal to r determinant of a. Any one of this we can use here. This is equal to, now see here, a11 into a22, multiply these two, 5 into 2, 10, minus, this minus sign will be as such, with that, multiply these two, 1 into, minus 1 into 4 is minus 4. Now minus of minus sign will become plus, so this is equal to 10 plus 4 equal to 14. 5 into 2, 10, minus sign, this cross we have to multiply, minus of minus, so minus 1 into 4 is minus 4. Now just add up these two, minus into minus will become plus here, so this is 10 plus 4 equal to 14. So the value of this determinant is 14. So the value of the determinant is 14. See, the next is determinant of order 3. We have to find the determinant of matrix of order 3. Now see, determinant of matrix of order 3 can be determined by expressing it in terms of second order determinants. See here, for if it is of order 2, then easily we can multiply the diagonal elements and then we can subtract and we can write the value. Suppose if it is of 3 cross 3 like this, what we are going to do here is we are going to reduce this and to the order of 2 second order determinant, and then we are going to solve this one. See, this is a reducing, we can say it as expansion of the determinant, either along row wise we can do or along column wise we can do here. Now for this expansion, see, first let us do with expansion along first row. This is my row 1. Now see here, how to do this expansion along this row 1 we have to do. Just listen. Now see here, the first element is A11. Now the first element A11 of this row 1. How to write this is A11 of row 1. Take this A11. It is at which place we have to see that row and that column we have to leave as such. We should not consider any number in this one. Suppose if I am taking this row, first element means this row should be completely deleted. This column should be completely deleted. Now what is left over I am having, that will be a 2 cross 2 matrix. Now for this A11, I have reduced to A22, A23, A32, A33. Now, with this, I have to see what is the sign for this also. What is that is, including this minus 1 whole power I plus j. For each and everything we have to have this one, minus 1 of I plus j. Y means for that particular place, what is a sign? Because we are leaving this row and we are leaving this column. While leaving this, we should not change anything there. So minus 1 of I plus j will give the exact sign for that particular place there. So minus 1 of I plus j. Now, what is the I here? 1. What is the j here? 1. So this is equal to minus 1 of 1 plus 1 A11 of A22, A23, A32, A33. 3, 3. Now, if it is so, now how to write this one? This is equal to minus 1 of power 2 will be there. So, minus 1 whole square A11. Now, we know how to find the value of this determinant. Just cross multiply this one. A22 into A33 minus next side A32 into A23. Now, minus 1 whole square will become plus 1. So, as usual will be there. This is first row, first element. Now, first row, second element we have to write. This is first, next one, let us write for second. Now, for second element A21, write the same thing, minus 1 of I plus J will be there as such, A12. Now see here, for this A12 is in which row? That row we have to delete, and that column also we have to delete. Leave this row and leave this column. We should not take any elements. The remaining four elements we have to take. This, that is A21, A23, A31, A33. Now, this is equal to I and J is 1 and 2. So, minus 1 of 1 plus 2 A12 A21 A23 A31 A33. Now, this is equal to minus 1 whole power 3. That is minus 1 only. So, minus A12, multiply this, cross multiply, A21, A33, minus A31, A23. This is for first row, second element. Now, first row, third element, let us write. First row, third element. Now, minus 1 of I plus J will be there. First row, third element is A13. So, A13 is equal to, now see here, this is the row and this column we have to leave. You have to delete this row and delete this column where the A13 element is there. The remaining determinant we have to take. So that is A21, A22, A31, A32. Now this we have write it as minus 1 of I and J is 1 and 3. 1 plus 3 A13 of A21, A22, A31, A32. This is equal to minus 1 power 4 will become plus here. So, plus A13, write this determinant, A21 into A32 minus A31 into A22. This is along the first row. The expansion we have done along this first row. Now, using this 3, we can find the value of this determinant. That is, determinant of A equal to, see that, first row, first element answer, plus second row, second element, first row, second element answer, plus first row, third element answer. All these we have to add up. Now, see here, minus 1 whole square becomes plus 1, that is, A11, A22, A33, minus A32, A23. Next is minus A12, A21, A33, minus A31, A23. Next is plus A13, A21, A32, minus A31, A22. If I calculate this entire thing, that will be the value of the determinant A. This is along the first row. The same thing we can do for second row. Same thing we can do for third row. Same the expansion along column wise also we can do. That is for first column, second column, third column. Likewise, we can do for each and every row as well as every column. The next expansion along the column wise also we will do here. Now let us take any one column. Let us take the column 1 or column 2, column 3, any column we can take. Let us take the column 2 here. Do for the column 2. Now for column 2, what is the first element? A12. So A12, this is equal to, same thing we have to write, minus 1 of I plus J we have to write. Now next, A12 means this is A12, so leave this row and leave this column. These two things we have to leave, then the remaining will be A21, A23, A31, A33. This is equal into here A12 is there, so this is equal to A12 means I and J, so minus 1 of 1 plus 2, so A12. Now multiply these things, A21, A33 minus A31, A23. Now write the same for A. Next element is 22, so take that 22. Now for A22, now see here, for A22, now this is the column and this row we have to leave. If I leave this, then what will be there? A11, A33, A13 and A31. Only these four will be there. That four we have to take. So see here, A22 is equal to minus 1 of I plus J, A11, A13, A31, A33. Now this is equal to, this A22 will be here. So minus 1 of 2 plus 2, A22 of, multiply this, A11, A33 minus A31, A13. Now the next is A32. See here, this is the next number, A32. So A32 is equal to minus 1 of I plus J, A32. Now we have to write the, now see here, A32 means this row will not be there, 32 this column will not be there. If it is so, now these four elements we have to take, that is A11, A13, A21, A23. These four numbers we have to take. So that is A11, A13, A21, A23. This is equal to minus 1 of 3 plus 2, A32, multiply this, A11, A23, minus A21, A13. Now, determinant of A equal to this one, that is equal to, now add all the 3 here, minus 1 of 3, that is minus only, so minus A12, A21 into A33, minus a31 into a23. Next, minus 1 of 4 becomes plus, so plus a22 of a11, a33, minus a31, a13. Next, minus 1 of 5, so becomes minus only, so minus of a32, a11, a23, minus a21, a13. This will be the determinant value. Even if we are finding the determinant value using this one, or we are finding the determinant value using this one, both will be same. For both the things, we will get the same answer.